software. And he's already sent them email campaigns. They've opened them up. They've watched webinars, and I just learned something really great. I made a decision.
Ooh,
I'd like to schedule a demonstration with you, and you've got to see the software. When can we get this done?
Well, I'm really busy. I'm sorry. Demonstration, can we do this on Zoom or something? I'm really
busy. Yes, that would be perfect. In fact, that's the preferred option.
Boom, I'm trapped. Now it got me. I basically trapped myself, right?
Right, but that's not how it normally goes.
Okay.
The first step is, I don't want to change my software. And so what we're doing now is we're going, well, look, John, you opened our campaign. You watched a 35-minute presentation. It seems like you're investigating options. Tell me, are you really interested in changing your software or not? And
okay.
He's got to say yes or no.
Yeah, he's got to say yes or no. Why don't you try it this way? Let's reverse it. I don't want to change my campaign.
Okay. You don't want to change your campaign?
No, you say it. You're the prospect.
Claude, I've thought about it. I really don't want to change my software.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you. You're working. I mean, you're working with even if there was a company that could give you more services, be more efficient, save you maybe 10, 15 hours a week, make it so you could reduce your employees because you have something much more efficient. And you told me you had a customer service problem. When you have a problem or a technical issue, you're on hold for 15 minutes listening to really bad rap music. I mean, so even if there was something that could make it better, you wouldn't want to change.
Well, I would probably consider changing if I suppose I'd change.
But
after all, QuickBooks isn't doing great.
Okay. See, that's when maybe you want to do your features and benefits, or in your conversation in the beginning, they said, no, and you might want to ask it if there was one thing that company could do better. Because you don't want to badmouth your comp. What happens when we badmouth the competition?
You look like a typical salesperson.
Yeah. You know, what else would he say? You know, hey, they're a good company. Mark, if there was one thing they could do better, delivery time, customer service, more features, time saving, adding in better CRM and AI. If there was one thing they could add better, what do you think that'd be? What's your opinion?
Better order to cash system.
Better to order cash, boom. And if that's something your company has, maybe you got to jump in. You've got to find something, if you just see, he doesn't expect you to say, I don't blame you. You should, you don't want to change your company and everything. You're comfortable with it and everything. So even if you could make more money, save more time, have this or this, that wouldn't be worth considering, would it? Okay. So you're forcing him to stay in the conversation. Okay. You want right now, he's just going, oh, this is another company and everything. I don't want to change. I'm happy with where I am. You've got to find something, something that triggers him emotionally.
Yeah. Find something, find some pain point.
Yeah. And you've got to sound completely different than your competition. If we use the same, that's why I hate scripts. You remember that about me, Mark?
Yeah.
I hate scripts. Because all salespeople use the same language, the same scripted talk and everything like that. And guess what? The prospects heard it already. And they have replies. They have a default system. Well, we'll think about it. We're happy with who we are. And then they dismiss you. Okay. We've got to rock the boat somehow. You're not allowed to think about it. Okay. You guys may not.